Advanced data protection is our most advanced form of protection for customers' personal data in iCloud.
There he is, Apple's lead data security guard. Okay, fine, senior vice president of software engineering. And he's announcing the company's new, yes.
An advanced data protection.
Or what most techie people know as end-to-end encryption, a security feature to keep our data more secure. Apple will soon offer end-to-end encryption to most of iCloud, including backups of your device and messages, photos, notes, and more. It's a big step, which privacy groups have called on the company to make for years. What took so long?
Some of the steps we took over a decade ago in designing iCloud and the way we encrypted were necessary precursors to build toward this moment. And using end-to-end encryption for the other types of data, like passwords and browser history and so forth, helped prove out that technology.
What technology is that exactly? I asked Federighi to break down all of this and the bigger implications of security tools like this.
Can we take a picture here, a little selfie?
Allow me to explain end-to-end encryption with a photo.
Can I get like a bunny fingers?
Sure. I can't see where my fingers are, but.
Okay, now this photo lives in my iCloud Photos account. With Apple's standard data protection, which is what we all have now, the photo is encrypted by the device with a key that can unencrypt or unlock the photo. All that is encrypted while it goes to Apple's server, and Apple holds a key that can recover the photo. If hackers got access to Apple's servers and that key, they could see the photo. But if I had Apple's advanced data protection turned on, that selfie would be end-to-end encrypted, meaning Apple doesn't have the key at all and can't see or unlock that photo.
Well, now with advanced data protection, we're giving users the option to keep that key only on their devices, which means that even if an attacker were to successfully breach the cloud and access all that data, they'd lack the key to decrypt it.
So you'll never see that photo, Craig.
We do not want to see your photo.
Which gets to one of the biggest issues Apple's had with end-to-end encryption, data recovery. If you can't get into your device, you wouldn't be able to access your data because you're the only one with the key now. Apple doesn't have it.
But there are incidences, and you know we do see it happen, where customers not only lose their device, they also forget their device passcode.
Oh yes, it's like you've met my mother-in-law.
Well, I think we all have those. Yeah, and so in that case, if your mother-in-law had set up you, say, as her recovery contact, you would actually be able, with information you couldn't use directly, but that you could use to assist her, you'd be able to help her recover her data that was protected with advanced data protection.
Apple requires you set up a backup recovery method in case you need to recover end-to-end encrypted data. One option, a recovery contact, where you can set up a friend or family member to assist you with recovering info. There's also a recovery key option, so you can generate a key that you can print out and keep in a secure location. While Apple already had end-to-end encryption on services like Health and iCloud Keychain, the company's now bringing it to a total of 23 services. But you will have to turn it on yourself.
Why not make this something that's turned on by default?
A user activating this feature is taking on an additional responsibility. They're taking on responsibility for their data recovery, for setting up a recovery contact or securing a recovery key. All users may not be ready or willing to do that.
With this sort of encryption enabled, companies, even under court order, cannot hand over user data because they technically can't even get it themselves.
End-to-end encryption has long been great for user privacy, but awful for law enforcement and governments who are trying to get their hands on data to help investigate crimes. Is this something that weighed into Apple's decision as you roll this out?
We deeply appreciate the work of law enforcement and support the work of law enforcement. We view that we're really have the same mission at heart, which is to keep people safe. Ultimately, keeping customers' data safe has big implications on our safety more broadly. There's sensitive information that were an ill-intentioned attacker, whether that be a foreign adversary or organized crime, to get access to information of our political leaders or others who have particular secrets or access to systems could be disastrous for us all. And so we see this as important to accomplishing the mission we share, which is to keep users safe.
End-to-end encrypted iCloud backups will come to US users before the end of the year and be released globally in 2023. Does that include China?
Oh, yeah, we believe so. We want to roll out across the world.
Do you know how the Chinese government feels about this?
They have not told me.
In 2020, Reuters reported that Apple dropped plans to let iPhone users fully encrypt their backups after the FBI complained that the move would harm investigations. Was this at all part of Apple's delay?
No, I've heard that rumor, but I don't know where it came from.
In addition to all of this, Apple's also introduced a new message contact key verification, which further verifies the sender and receiver for those who require extreme security. You can also now use a hardware security key made by other companies, such as Yubico, to authenticate your Apple account.
What's the prompt for all these new security features? How much of it is aimed at Pegasus and other recent attacks?
As customers have put more and more of their personal information, of their lives, into their devices, these have become more and more the subject of attacks by advanced actors. The only way to ultimately secure against these things is to stay one step ahead of the attackers.
The next step, though, lies with us and whether we decide to turn on advanced data protection.